Professor P.J. Rao, Dr. Narahari Sastri, Registrar and Director Naipar Guwahati to lighten the lamp for the auspicious occasion. This will be followed by singing of the invocation song.
Guwahati. declare the convocation open.
The director of the institute, Dr. Iyasin Murthy, will now present the annual report of the institute for the academic years.
Honorable Chief Guest of this function, Professor Sahasrabudu Ji, Honorable Chairman of my Board of Governors, students, parents, and scholars, and my faculty. Good morning to all of you who have been awarded from this great institute. My special appreciation to the 2017-19 batch students who helped me in shifting from Guwahati Medical College to present Mirza campus and bailed me, spared me, and tolerated me. I can say that the 2018-19 is a colorful year for our institute, as it means it received many laurels in various forms. To provide a concrete and constructive support, a wonderful BOD is formed that is approved by the visiting President of India under the dynamic leadership of Dr. S. Chandrasekhar, Director of IASST Hyderabad. The body consists of eminent personalities from academia like IIT, industry like Pfizer, NATCO, etc. This is the first national institute in Northeast to receive the Northeastern Society Aspect for Translation, Phytopharmaceutical and Herbal Research Incubation.
Nurturing the entrepreneurs for scaling up the technologies under BioNest of BIRAC Incubation Center, supported by DBT with a funding of 5 crores for 3 years. We are planning to make a local traditional healers, this one with whom we are working for the last 2 years, and in order to make them as potential entrepreneurs. Establishment of National Center for Pharmaco-Engineering for designing the innovative drug delivery strategies to fight neglected and other diseases also is awarded by Department of Science and Technology with a budget of 5 crores for 3 years. This will be taken up by the Pharmaceutics Department as well as Pharmacology and Toxicology. Another center was awarded 2 months back by Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Center of Excellence, only to support the traditional healers who belongs to the traditional tribal community to make them as a potential entrepreneurs and give the product certification validation by providing the preclinical data from the Niper side. A total of 12 research projects we have been awarded from various funding agencies like DST, ICMR, Ministry of Environment and Forest and Ministry of Tribal Affairs with a total budget of approximately 7 crores. We are also an active stakeholder and we are actively participating with the IIT Guwahati with the Department of Mechanical Engineering, BSB, Civil Engineering in various subjects related to Niper Guwahati activities. I am also happy to share we have received almost 60 lakhs from IIT Guwahati by all our 5 departments under the Northeast Outreach Program. Right from 2008 to 2017, Niper Guwahati was running only 3 departments, and last year we have received 2 more new departments we have inducted, that is Pharmaceutics and Pharma Analysis. I am happy to share that BOG of Niper Guwahati yesterday has approved 2 more PhDs to Pharmaceutics and Pharma Analysis, and they will be inducted in the current academic session 2019-21. Under Skill Development Program, we have organized a workshop in collaboration with the CSIR NIST Jorhat on quantity control and quality assurance in the month of May that drawn the attention of many students and scholars. Some of our second year master students have taken up their projects not only in Niper, other than Niper like CSIR IACT, CSIR CCMB, CSIR IGAB, Institute of Liver and Biology Sciences, and the National Institute of Biologicals, Noida, for their 8 to 10 months dissertation projects. For the past 1 year, Niper Guwahati is well equipped with the state of art instruments like small angle image system and all, which is a unique one available in India and in Asia as well, supplied by Fuji Films, Netherlands. We are running our show with minimum manpower and giving maximum output. At present, we have 9 faculty, 1 scientific officer, 1 incubation manager, and 6 RAs. For the last 2 years, this institute could publish 56 and publications in highly reputed journal and filed 5 patents. I am happy to share that after Naipar Mohali, this is the second Naipar to have its own permanent campus, which is located in lush greenery environment near Chansari, which is 8 kilometers from IIT. We are planning to move to our new campus in 2000 to start our new academic session 1921 with the first batch, with new hopes, new ideas, new challenges, if sufficient funds are provided by ministry. Approximately 2 lakh square feet construction is getting ready for occupation for academic block, laboratories, hostels, and staff quarters. I am confident that convocation, fourth convocation of Naipar Guwahati will be held in the new campus in the next year. And we are also actively involved in the industry academia. We have entered into MOUs with many, many companies for the last 12 months. To name one of the yesterday event, in the presence of BOG, we had an MOU with BVG Life Sciences, Pune, and another academic institution, which is upcoming institution, Global University, Guwahati. Our future program in new campus are big ambitious, like establishment of high performance computing for drug discovery by having supercomputing facility from CDEC as well as IIT Guwahati as well. We also initiated the program on the GMP certified testing laboratory and the first of its kind of animal breeding facility, as there is no animal breeding supplier in entire Northeast region. In a couple of years, Naipar Guwahati will be the first institute not only for the GMP testing lab, but also to provide quality animals to various R&D and other academic institutions of Northeast region. This will enable to supply the quality animals to the various parts. Expecting productive journey in progressive direction by our promising faculty with our positive BOG. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Dr. S. Anujikar, Chairman, Board of Governors, Naipar Guwahati, to address the gathering.
Greetings to all the graduating students and the proud parents. It's also a pleasure for me to welcome our chief guest today, Professor Anil Sahasrabuddeji, Chairman, All India Council of Technical Education, Government of India. I also want to welcome the fellow members of the Board of Governors, the faculty, the parents, the media, and other friends who are watching this program live. It must be a very great and proud moment to all the young minds sitting in this auditorium today and receiving their degrees from a very illustrious personality, Professor Sahasrabuddeji. While Naipar Guwahati has been a dream institute for the nation, which has been built by the Ministry of Department of Pharmaceuticals, which come under the Chemicals and Fertilizers Group of Government of India, I also convey greetings to all of you from the fellow directors of Naipar and also the Ministry of Fertilizers and Chemicals. This would be the first convocation for this Naipar Guwahati. I'm also pleased to announce that of all the Naipars which got the BOGs for the first time, this would be the first convocation and remain in the history as the first convocation. I'm also privileged to greet Professor Yosin Muthi, who has mentored this organization for the last 3 years, who has gained a lot of wisdom while running as a project director at Naipar Hyderabad, and then as a very senior most chief scientist at IASST Hyderabad. He brought in a lot of diversity to this Northeast region and made sure that this institute is always bubbling. Just to reiterate, while on one side you are very delighted that you are receiving your degrees, it's also not a very pleasant moment that you are losing the studenthood today. Once you lose the studenthood and you become the responsible citizen of the nation, new challenges with a lot of new opportunities would be ahead of all of you. I am sure while you enjoyed your student education and student life, I am sure you become the responsible citizens and make all of us proud that you live in a developed nation, not the so-called developing nation. You always have seen this country has progressed well, while I belong to at least two generations ahead of you, or 1.5 generations ahead of you. We have seen the growth of this nation from a country where even to get a Bajaj Chetak scooter took 8 years of waiting, and to buy a Maruti 800 car in 1994 for 1.7 lakhs, which was the best car available those days, and you had to shell down another 80,000 to get on advance, otherwise you had to wait for 2 more years. A land telephone took 6 years in our nation, and a gas cylinder took 5 years. So I and many of the leaders sitting on the dais belong to that era. Whereas all of you belong to an era where entire world have come to me. You have a smartphone which connects you to the world, and you get what you want. I'm sure this artificial intelligence, what this world has created to all of us, don't treat it as your competition. Please treat artificial intelligence as your partner. Once you trust your partner, I'm sure with your intelligent minds and the data what you get from artificial intelligence, both hand in hand, I'm sure this country would be the number one nation on this planet. You are very privileged to be part of the northeast part of this nation. There's a lot of natural wealth, and this young lot, instead of expecting jobs elsewhere, please create jobs. Rather than a job seeker, please become a job giver. I'm sure the current government is encouraging Startup India. There are several incubation centers coming across the country. I'm sure you take this advantage. Take a chance for 2 years. There's no harm in taking a chance in life for 2-3 years. Start a company without looking for a job. Explore for 2-3 years. If you are not very successful, I'm sure whole world is open for you to take up jobs again. I also would like to mention, many a times, if you are adopted by some other member in the family, your family name will change. Sometimes in southern part of the country and also in the north, if you marry, sometimes you change your family name to the newly married husband's family name. But please remember, the alma mater remains permanent. You cannot change that you belong to the alma mater, Naipur Guwahati. So I do wish that you make this alma mater a proud organization of this country, and you would stand in the top 3 rankings of pharmaceutical institutes in the country. I am sure 2 Naipurs already appear in top 10, but I have no doubt under the leadership of Dr. Yosan Murthy and advisors from the Board of Governors, and with all the national wealth you have, this Naipur would stand among top 3 in the next 5 years. I'm also confident that those who have not received gold medals would not mind too seriously. Gold medal is just a small achievement in life. Most of us sitting on the dais, I don't think, are gold medalists, but they went on to become leaders of the nation. There are some requirements. While gold medal is for smartness in the classroom, you need to be smart in the real world classroom. And once you are smart in the real world classroom, I'm sure you will beat many, many toppers, including Stanford's and Harvard's. I'm sure this exciting morning would be carried for you your lifetime. And those parents who have really worked very hard to see this day for all of you, that you graduate and become responsible citizens of this country, I'm sure this day has come. I wish all of you a great success. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. The guest of honor of the 3rd convocation of Naipur Guwahati is Dr. Narahari Sastry, Director, CSR, Mr. Jorhat. May I request Dr. Narahari Sastry to address the gathering.
Good morning, all of you. My dear students who are going to graduate today and their parents. And the chief guest of the function, Professor Anil Sahasrabuddhi ji, who has spent 19 years of his life in Northeast and has a lot of understanding of the technical education system in the country. And the Chairman of Board of Governors, Dr. S. Chandrasekhar, who has mentored NIPER Hyderabad and took it to a great heights. And under his leadership, Dr. U.S. Murthy was also the coordinator in charge director of NIPER Hyderabad for several years. And Dr. U.S. Murthy, who has been in Northeast for several decades, working with many people, and we are all lucky to have such a dynamic director who has taken the initiative to a great heights. And if I were to say the person who has spent more than four decades in Northeast, and especially Assam, is Professor Dr. P.G. Rao, who has started his career from RRL Jorhat. And he was director for more than 10 years, and then he continued to be around East Jorhat and several members of the Board of Governors. We are all excited to be associated with NIPER Guwahati, and the rate at which it is progressing in the last 2 years is highly commendable. And as our Chairman Board of Governors mentioned, that the backbone of the institute is the students. And these students should be very fortunate when they are in the formative stages of the institute. There are some challenges and there are some lacunae, but there will be lots of camaraderie. There will be lots of, it's like a family, right? When you are within 100, you will be knowing each other, and then there is a lot of possibilities that you have. And I am sure that under the able leadership of Dr. U.S.N. Murthy and the assistance of everybody in the Northeast and the Board of Governors and people like Dr. Shahasubuddhi Ji, Dr. P.G. Rao, this initiative will definitely come with flying colors. And the range of things that Dr. U.S.N. Murthy has been talking about, whether it is metabolic engineering to medicinal chemistry to pharmacology or artificial intelligence, computational modeling, drug discovery. He has so much energy, and I wish God gives him enough strength to contribute something to the Northeast. It is already making a strong name at national level, and I would like this institute to be one of the topmost institutes in the world in pharmaceutical education research is concerned. Because Dr. Shahasrabuddhi, we were talking about, he started the NERIST as a very small organization in 1986. Now it has 1800 students. And the campus in which we are staying, IASST, also has started as a very small venture when the Shillong Science Congress has happened, the DST has taken. And this has become one of the very, very topmost institute in the Northeast. And NIPERS are really the top class institutes, and with the current enthusiasm of the government and with strong directors.
And we also have Dr. Ravichandran from NIPER Kolkata, and there is a lot of camaraderie among the directors, among the Board of Governors and the ministry. And with all these things, let NIPERS be the proud jewels in the crown of India. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Director NIPER Guwahati to administer the exhortation. The recipients of the degrees are requested to stand up and remain standing till the exhortation is over.
Sir, the students of NIPER Guwahati.
Let there be no neglect of prosperity. Let there be no neglect of learning and teaching. Whatever deeds are blameless are to be practiced, not others. Whatever good practices
who are lovers of truth, this is instruction. You shall take all this as the guiding philosophy of your life. Serve your country and nation with all your might, irrespective of any region, religion, caste, or community. May I introduce to you the students who have already been considered fit by Naipar Guwahati to receive the degrees of the institute to which I pray they may be admitted.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the chairman BOG Naipar Guwahati, I admit you.
The presentation of the institute gold medals. Register will announce the name of the medal winners and the chairman BOG and the chief guest of today's function are requested to present the medals and the certificates to the recipients.
The Institute Gold Medal won for each of the discipline is awarded to the student who ranks first, obtaining the highest cumulative performance index among all the eligible students in that particular year. For the years 2017, 2018, and 2019, I present to you, sir, the Institute Gold Medal winners. For the batch 2015-17, Z. Naresh Kumar from Biotechnology.
Elvin Jolie, pharmacy practice. For the batch 2016-18, none are present. So for the batch 2017-19, Sasla Thasni C from Biotechnology. Sneha Rajendra from Pharmacology and Toxicology. Om Prakash Kumar Thakur from Pharmacy Practice. The following medal winners could not be present due to their reasons. So, K. Humangas from Pharmacology and Toxicology, 40-year present, 15-17. Abia Johnson, Biotechnology, 40-year 2016-18. Y. Monin, Pharmacology and Toxicology, 2016-18. Urima Sneha S., Pharmacy Practice, 2016-18. We'll hand over the medals to them through the Institute. Thank you.
The seat guest of the third convocation of NIPER Guwahati is Professor Anil Dattatreya Sahasrabuddhe, who is the chairman of All India Council for Technical Education. Professor Sahasrabuddhe is an academician and educational administrator for excellence. He was a professor of mechanical engineering at IIT Guwahati. Later, he became the deputy director of the institute. He was a director of the College of Engineering at Pune. After his assignment at College of Engineering Pune, he was appointed as the chairman of AICT in July 2015 and holding the position till date. May I now request Professor Anil D. Sahasrabuddhe to deliver the convocation address.
Namaskar, good morning to all of you. Chairman of Board of Governors, Dr. S. Chandrasekhar, to the Director of CSIR IICT at Hyderabad, Dr. U.S.M. Murthy, Director of National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, Guwahati, Dr. G. Narahari Sastri, Dr. P.J. Rao, Dr. U.C. Das, members of the Board of Governors of NIPER, Deans, Heads of the Departments, distinguished faculty members, guests, persons from the media, and most important of all, graduating students and their parents. It's indeed a great pleasure to be amongst you on this very important auspicious occasion in your lives, the third convocation of NIPER. In fact, I was noting that 2 to 3 batches of students are being given degrees in single convocation, and the Board of Governors has decided to have annual feature of convocation. That's a good, very good step that has been taken, because it is the right time when you just graduate, when you get that certificate, you feel pleased about it. And that's why it's very, very important. Government of India started several institutions, but almost then, Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers, which has started series of NIPERs. Today there are 7 in number, are specialized institutions in pharmaceutical education and research. So this is very, very important for the nation, because we all depend on healthcare, medicines. These are all very significant and important. Dr. Murthy Garu, who invited me to this convocation as the chief guest, and I could say no, for 2 reasons. Number one, as pointed out by my earlier predecessor speakers, that I spent my first 19 years of my job in the Northeast, starting with Itanagar in Nearest. And then that was also a new institution which was beginning to happen. And then IIT Guwahati, which also just started, I was a beginner there. In both the institutions, I am there in the very first year itself in its formation. And that love for Northeast will always attract me back whenever there is an opportunity. That was the number one reason. Number two reason, Dr. Murthy Garu's son was a student of mine in IIT Guwahati. So when a student's father asked me, how can I say no to that? And that's how I'm here for the third convocation. I think this is a very beautiful place, Guwahati, well known for its Kamakhya temple, mighty Brahmaputra. But it's also home for well-known Cotton College State University, one of the very oldest institutions in this northeastern region, Assam Science and Technology University, University of Guwahati, also pretty old, IIT Guwahati, there is IIIT, and now the NIPER. So I think there is an excellent combination of institutions of all breeds and variety. Also, Guwahati Medical College was pharmacy and medicine have very, very fond relationship. And therefore, the right institution, right ecosystem exists. And the kind of development that Dr. Murthy presented in his director's address makes all of us proud. 3 crore project grant from Department of Science and Technology, 5 crore grant for another activity for fighting diseases and developing those pharmaceuticals.
Center of Excellence for Tradition in Healing, which is also very important because there are 8 northeastern states with the flora and fauna that exists here. There are lots of traditional medicines out of herbs. And unless we really understand them, how and why they function, the way they function, and also probably patent and start developing new medicines, I think this knowledge will be lost. And that's why this is a very important initiative which has been approved and then you are taking it up.
New campus, director said that it is upcoming, more than 2.5 lakh square feet area. You will not be in a congested atmosphere like this. There will be a lot of opportunities for sports, for debate, discussion. I think you will have hostels within the campus, so you will have a lovely place, but you will not have it. But your juniors who will join this institution in the years to come will enjoy that. But I keep saying that the first few batches, they go through all kind of difficulties. I have experienced that in 2 institutions. So I know, as Dr. Murari Shastri rightly pointed out, that in the formative years, there is a strong bonding between students and teachers. And that slowly diminishes as the institute grows in size. Today probably, you know all faculty members and all faculty members know you by names, which will not be the case after 5-10 years when you are in the campus with 5,000 students. And that's why this bond homie between you and the teachers, you will enjoy and relish throughout your lives. And that is a significant thing. And you will have all difficulties. You will have not proper lab, sometimes no accommodation, sometimes in accommodation where you will have to share resources, there is a water problem, all kind of things. But despite all that, these first batches of students are the ones who excel in life because they have gone through difficulties. So they can take up any challenge which comes their way with a smiling face and succeed in overcoming that and find innovative solutions. And that is what I have found the few batches of NERIST as well as IIT Guwahati. I don't say that present batches will not do well, but the first batches have a tremendous potential which they would have exhibited. And that is what I'm sure that all of you will be doing. So coming back, dear graduates, I congratulate all of you for receiving your degrees and some of you gold medals. But the life begins from now. So whatever degrees you have earned in an educational institution in a very cozy atmosphere will not be there in the outside life. Outside there will be more challenges. Although you have faced challenges here, those challenges outside would be much more. So your interaction with your fellow scientists, fellow employees, your boss, your juniors, I think that communication between you and them is going to mold you in the future. And that's why those seeds are sown here. The learnings which you have done here will be a great succor to you when you go out. But what you should remember is the hard work done by your teachers on you for training you, the excellence that is being built up under you, in you, and the parents who have struggled to send you for higher education. Many a times there are first generation learners whose parents would not have had any education at all or barely education up to maybe class 10, 12. But such parents also will have in their mind and heart that at least my child should become a graduate and shine in the world outside. And their difficulties, their commitment, their sacrifices, these are very important, and you must remember sacrifices of your parents, your relatives, your brothers and sisters, because whenever there is a difficulty, you would have called. Earlier, Chandrasekhar Garu said that there were no telephones during our time, so we couldn't call anyone. Today you can call your parents, your friends. But what is significant is they have given you all that what you have today. So remember your parents, family members, teachers, and not only this, but your friends. Because it is your friends with whom you stayed for whatever period you stayed here in the institution for your graduation, post-graduation and PhD time. You would have intense debate, discussions, and those memories will always cherish all throughout your life. And whenever you find some difficulty in life, you can always fall back upon them, because today the connection, networking is much easier and much more immediately possible than what used to be about 20, 30 years ago. So you have Facebook, you have Twitter, you have Instagram, your email, your SMSs, so you can instantly call your friend who is in a similar situation or in a different institution or organization, and how did you solve this problem, you know, and then get the solution for that and then can implement it. And therefore, please keep in contact with your friends, but don't forget the alma mater. The alma mater is the one which has given you all this what you have gained, and as an alumnus of this institution, you have a role to play. Many times, most of the people think whenever an institution calls back an alumni, they may be interested in some donation and funds. That is, of course, is necessary for an institution to develop more facilities of research, better facilities for the next generation of students. But what is significant is your connect, because it is like mother and child relationship. That umbilical relationship will not be cut off. It has to remain. And that's why, as often as possible, please come back to the institution and give in whatever form you can. It is not necessary that you should always give, as I said, donations. But you can come and give a lecture to your junior students about what you have been doing now in your different organization, what kind of research you have done, what kind of future things are happening, and if possible, you can give scholarship to one or two students who are not from good families with a strong background. You can also have a role of mentor, you know. You can give them succor in terms of what they need to do in the future, career guidance. There are several things which an alumnus can do for his organization, alma mater, and please do that. We all tell that whatever we were taught in the institution or universities is going to be outdated by the time, probably when you go out of the campus itself. And that is the way the technologies are changing rapidly, whether it is in engineering, technology, medicine, whether it is in pharmacology, pharmacy. Whatever you have learned here may be of help sometime, but immediately something new emerges and you have to get adjusted and you learn by yourself. And therefore, self-learning and lifelong learning, these two twin paradigms are going to be very, very important in your lives. So do remember that whatever you have learnt is not enough. This is only a stepping stone for the life outside, but you have to start learning on your own whatever new things are coming up. And how do you get that? And again, compared to 25, 30 years back, technology has enabled you. So you don't have to go to a teacher's, hunt for a book in a library which is not there in your region, travel to get a good book from the library. That is not necessary, because on internet, on YouTube, on the platforms like MOOCs, you have courses which are available in all domains. In fact, our own national MOOCs platform called as SWAYAM, study webs for active learning by young and aspiring minds, that is SWAYAM. SWAYAM in Hindi, Sanskrit, Assamese, Bengali, Hindi is self. So self-learning. So this is a platform where there are already 2,700 courses. More than 3 million, 30 lakh students are making use of this today. Our target is 3 crore, tenfold increase in the number of students simultaneously using this platform. And I'm very happy to tell you that there are several platforms of this nature from top universities of the world like MIT, which is called edX. Stanford has Coursera, but our Indian platform is competing with them with the number of users and the number of countries who are using it. 120 countries today use Indian SWAYAM portal. So that means wherever we put in our best efforts,
with commitment, we can challenge the world. And that's what is the advice to all of you, that you have great potential, only it has to be brought out. And it is in this context that very few faculty members who are there in the organization today, I think that is another area which this institution has to immediately address to get full-time more faculty members so that more research can happen. We should talk to the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. Whatever is possible, I will also try to pitch in and help in doing that. And once we have more faculty members on campus, I think more outcomes will start emerging from out of this institution. And I'm linking it to faculty. Although there are very few faculty who are engaged today, we need to have highly committed faculty members. That is the highest need of the hour. Because compared to what we were thousands of years ago in a traditional Gurukula system or in a formal university system of Nalanda and Takshila, we used to have 1:10, 1:5 student-teacher ratio. Students used to come from all over the world to study here in this country. But unfortunately today, most of our graduates want to step out and go to USA or Canada or Germany or France or Japan or Australia to study abroad. I want that we should change this equation in the next couple of decades. The entire world should start coming to India for getting the knowledge, and that is our capability. So we should not forget our capability based on our ancient past and the future, which is very, very bright. The government, the way it has been announcing more funding for research and education, with the gross enrollment ratio having touched 28%, our aim of 30% by 2020 within our reach, and maybe 40%, 50%, which we are debating, we will be one of the most advanced nations of the world, whether it is in business. We all know that ease of doing business, we are jumping places. In terms of innovation, we are jumping places from where we were about just 5-10 years ago. So there is a trajectory which is very clearly towards an excellent growth for the nation. And who will do it? Not us with grey hair, because you have spent our more than 3/4 of the journey, but you are the ones who are coming into this journey, and the nation depends on you, and I'm sure that you will contribute towards the might of the nation. And please remember again Dr. Kalam, who used to often say that this is the only country which spread itself in terms of education and culture all over the world, but not sword in the hand. We always are a peaceful country. We might have been attacked by several others, but we never attacked any country. And with that spirit, if you move around the globe with 1.3 billion population, which is 1/6 of the entire globe, I think we can change the entire globe towards peace, prosperity, and happiness. With these few words, once again, I congratulate all of you for your degrees and the life ahead, and my best wishes for you in your future career. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for inspiring our students with your valuable words. Now we shall start awarding degrees to the students in absence here. Director of the institute is requested to administer the same, and registrar is requested to call the names of the students in absence here.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the chairman, board of governors of my faculty, I admit those candidates whose names are given in the list, but they are not present today to their respective degrees in absentia.
I shall now call the names of the students in absence here. For class 2015-17, Department of Biotechnology, M. Madhuri, Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology, Arpit Malik, Vijay Bahadur Singh, V. Kedarnath, G. Anand Reddy, Pankaj Chopra, Amit Kumar Mishra, K. Vimal Raj, Sushant Jagdish Paul, Akhilesh Kumar Bais, Priya Ravindra Shavan, Duri Rajagopal, Mitali Tripathi, Nitendra Kumar, Anurag Sahu, Narendra Singh, now for the Department of Pharmacy Practice, Ramit Kumar Guhats, Diksha K. Paul. Now for the batch 2016-18, Department of Biotechnology, Abhiya Johnson, Sasikant U. Patil, Bijoy Kumar G. Agarwal, T. Manasa, Mahesh, Prajakta Prakash Deshmukh. For the Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology, Sagar Saha, Kunaki Shatna, Achyuta P. Rani, Shah Smith Mitesh Kumar, Arjun Prasad P., Y. Monika, Anupam Agnihotri, Bahari Tahir Chabir, Abdul Jalil Kevi, Antra Pant, Deepak Kumar Sahu, Gosika Apurva, Indrakant Kalpana, Madhugula Madhavi, Suha Kumari, Tajisha U. Lohe. For the Department of Pharmacy Practice, Rayaz Ahmad Bhatt, Purnima Snehoy S., K. M. Asha Sohan, K. M. Ranjana, Jerry Putula Harish, Jenny Beno Lotha. For the batch 2017-18-19, Pharmacology and Toxicology, Pragya Kumari. Thank you.
Now we start the awarded degrees to the students who are present today. Director of the institute is requested to administer the same and registrar is requested to call the names of the students present.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the chairman, Board of Governors, Nepal Guwahati, I admit you to the degree of Master of Sciences, MS Pharma, and Master of Pharmacy of the institute and charge you to be worthy of the same.
For the batch 2015-17, Department of Biotechnology, Kumari Fabhya. Z. Naresh Kumar. Sapara Mohim Arvind Bhai, Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology, Vikas Kumar Roy. Indu Sandran J.S. T.P. Narasimha. For the Department of Pharmacy Practice, Abin Johnny, photographs 2016-18, Department of Biotechnology, Kolingundu, Sirisha. Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology, Sandeep Kumar. Service O KGO. Department of Pharmacy Practice, Fishal Tiwari. For the batch 2017-19, Department of Biotechnology, G.V. Satyasairam. Mohammad Ravi Bajaj. A. Deladoni. Shalu Singh. Sushmita Mishra. G. Thanthosi. Silvery Maheshwari. Sahla Thasni C. Megha Gautam. For the Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology, Asha Gautam. Saif Kashif.
Ishaji Panda. K. Hima Barsa. Palepu M. Kumar.
Arup Kumar Bishoyi. M. Mastan Mukram. Wow. Samir Ranjan Panda, Dibhya D. Sneha Rajendra, Lakhan Lal Sahu, Shinde L. Bhagwan, K. Harrison Rathod, Jala Nikhil, Priyanka, Ashish Kumar Damle, Batula Monica, Akanksha Mills, Shauranga Bai Gaikwad, for the Department of Pharmacy Practice, Sinju George, Om Prakash Kumar Thakur, Ranju Mishra, S. Kedar Tanaji, Sabnam Fasal Rahiman, S. Shruti Srinivas, Amal Prasad, P. Prajakta Jagdish, Hari R. Erika Ibha Nangri, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. May I request Chairman BOG, Naipaul Guwahati, to declare closing of the convocation proceedings.
I declare the convocation closed.
Thank you, sir. As a token of respect, now we would like to felicitate our chief guest, Chairman BOG, and guest of honor, and the BOG members. On behalf of the Institute, I would like to request Chairman BOG to felicitate our chief guest, Professor A.B. Sahasrabode, and the guest of honor, Professor Narahari Sastri. Now I request Chairman BOG to felicitate Professor Narahari Sastri. Director of Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate the Chairman BOG, Dr. S. Chandrasekhar. Now, I would like to request Director of Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Dr. P. Z. Rao. Now I would like to request Director Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Professor L. K. Ghosh. Now I would like to request Director to felicitate Professor Alok Mittal. I would like to request Director Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Professor Rohit Srivastava. I would like to request Director Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Dr. Anirudh Naidu. Now I would like to request Director Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Mr. Gopal Das. Now I would like to request Director Naipaul Guwahati to felicitate Mr. Mabajit Boro. Thank you, sir. The organizing committee would like to thank the chief guest and the chairman BOG and all the BOG members for sparing their valuable time to attend this convocation. Our heartfelt thanks goes to all parents of the graduating students for their esteemed presence. Our thanks also goes to the director and other officials of IASST for making available their premises for organizing the event in the best way possible. We would also like to thank the media for covering the program. We would like to thank our director, dean, registrar, and all faculty members and staff for the kind cooperation. We also extend our gratitude to all the graduating students without whose presence this program would have not been possible. Finally, our thanks goes to all the current students and to all those who are directly and indirectly associated with the organization of the third convocation of NIPAL Guwahati for the kind cooperation. Now, the national anthem will be sung and the academic procession will leave the hall at the end of the national anthem. All are requested to stand up and remain standing till the academic procession leaves the hall.
हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन जन मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता
are requested to proceed for lunch arranged in the food court near the guest house.